Delve into the comments of a ginger cat acting silly video, and you're likely to find mentions of orange cat behaviour. Believe it or not, scientists have actually investigated whether or not coat colour has any impact on cat behaviour. So what is orange cat behaviour, and is it actually a real phenomenon? The aptly named orange gene is on the X chromosome and is responsible for the orange cats producing the pigment pheomelanin that gives them their signature colour. Being on the X chromosome, the orange gene is sex-linked, meaning that a cat's sex chromosomes can actually affect their colour. Cats with one X chromosome can either be orange or non-orange, only needing one mutation to become a lovely pumpkin hue. Cats with two X chromosomes can have up to two copies of the gene, so need two mutations to be completely orange. Because of this genetic quirk, there are around 3 males for every 1 female ginger cat. There is a prevalent myth that male cats are more friendly than female cats, which if true would likely be a reason why more people find ginger cats more friendly, but the reality is that that is still an unknown. Cats are certainly expressive little creatures, with a recent study identifying 276 unique feline facial expressions and a 2021 study identifying 7 distinct personality traits. The orange cat behaviour meme portrays orange cats as lovable agents of chaos that are a touch more foolish than their feline brethren. Some studies suggest there may be a link between behaviour and coat colour. However, there is no significant or conclusive evidence, and the consideration of coat colour is not something that shapes our decision-making process when considering differentials in why the cat may be behaving in a certain way. The researchers focused on human perceptions of cat personality, surveying 189 cat owners on the personalities of their feline companions. They found that orange cats were rated relatively high in friendliness and low in aloofness and shyness compared to the other colours of kitty. White cats were seen as more aloof, shy, calm, and low in activity, friendliness, and boldness. Black cats didn't have any traits that were rated particularly differently from other colours. Bicoloured cats were perceived as friendly and low in aloofness, and tricoloured cats seen as aloof, intolerant, and low in friendliness. However, this all comes down to people's subjective observations of cats. Why is the orange cat personality perceived as being different? The study authors suggest that it may be down to how they're portrayed in the media, with certain orange cat cartoon characters shaping people's perceptions. Interestingly, depictions of some of the most well-known orange cats in American culture, such as Morris, the world's most finickety cat, and Garfield, who's described as lazy and cynical, are not positive. However, based on sales and advertising, these two cat characters are hugely popular within the United States. One possibility is that the tendency for orange cats to be highly anthropomorphized in advertising and other popular media influences their popularity. So could the breed of a cat influence their behaviour? Breed doesn't play as significant a role in behaviour as some people may think, but it plays more of a role in a cat's behaviour than coat colour, for example. What we do know about breeds is that the health conditions can be more inheritable than behaviour traits, and the development of certain breeds has contributed to cats having diminished welfare and well-being. We know breeds with extreme conformities, such as brachycephalic, with a shorter skull, much like in pugs, can suffer breathing and eating difficulties. The study authors hypothesised that pleiotropy, where a gene influences two or more traits, could unintentionally happen in selecting for a particular colour. However, their hypothesis that associations between appearance and behaviour would occur independently of breed was largely unsubstantiated. Nearly all associations between behaviour and coat type could be attributed to breed-based behaviour differences. In their opinion, both nature and nurture were the most important factors in how a cat will behave throughout their life. Although breed and coat colour don't seem to have a huge influence on how a cat will behave, some traits do seem to have some roots in genetics. Nature or genetics is also significantly important. For example, boldness, aka confidence, is thought to be an inheritable genetic trait. The nurture part of the question relates to good socialisation during the sensitive socialisation period of 2 to 7 weeks. A good socialisation plan is one of the greatest tools in affecting the behaviour of a cat. So there we have it. Your orange cat may indeed be a very silly little guy, but their charmingly odd behaviour is probably not linked to their coat colour. Thank you for watching IFL Science. Hit that subscribe button for more science videos.